What is going on, everybody? Welcome back for another brand new video. Today we're going to be covering the PS5 update for The Witcher 3 and everything we need to know about it so far. The details are still a little scarce, but we did find a new article to dive into this week. It came out about 2 days ago, so it's the most recent update we have. So we're going to dive into that. I know the first Witcher 3 PS5 update video we did was very well received, so we're going to cover it again for you guys since that's something you guys do enjoy. As always with these videos, if you guys enjoy the content, please be sure to smash the thumbs up button. Consider subscribing to the channel if you guys are new. And consider subscribing. Make sure to just comment that down below. Let us know you're a new subscriber so we can welcome you to the channel properly. And as always, just turn on the notification bell so you guys never miss uploads. Be on the lookout for our 1,000 subscriber giveaway. It's mentioned in all the other videos, so if you want to go back and look at it, it's also in the description below, kind of telling you the details. So just be on the lookout for that. But as always, let's get into it. So this article is from ScreenRant.com, and it's called Everything the Witcher 3 PS5 Upgrade Includes by Kyle Grattan. It has been over 6 years since The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt released, and it remains one of the most beloved RPGs to the point where it's getting a next-gen upgrade for the PS5 and PC. Fans of the game who played on console will have a chance to relive the final chapter of Geralt's journey with a new coat of paint. The Witcher 3 comes to PS5 and Xbox Series X and S later this year. The next-gen upgrade was announced last year without a specific release date, but CD Projekt Red has confirmed it's still coming in 2021. CDPR's silence on the release date carries over to all other information concerning the new version of The Witcher 3, as well as with a few details being given by the developer. The Witcher brand has grown into popularity since the release of The Witcher 3, in part due to the popularity of the Netflix series. The CDPR game series, which started in 2007, is based on the Polish fantasy novels and short stories by, I'm not even going to bother saying his name, Andrzej Sapkowski. I got commented on this last time. So if you're Polish, feel free to correct me. The Witcher 3 certainly propelled the IP into the gaming mainstream, but the franchise itself began to enter into the wider pop culture until more recently. Many new fans coming from the Witcher Netflix series may now have a chance to try the game for the first time. The next generation version of The Witcher 3 was initially confirmed by the Witcher Twitter account in September 2020. Since then, there's been very little information disclosed aside from the fact that the current owners of the game can upgrade for no additional charge. CDPR calls it a visually and technically enhanced version of the game that will likely have quite a few technical changes since it's also being re-released on PC. It was implied that the initial announcement by the use of an image that features the complete edition that the PS5 version of The Witcher 3 would include all DLC. This seems to have been confirmed by a reveal of the new cover art. This too bears the complete edition banner, along with the announcement of the DLC inspired by Netflix series being added as well. This means that The Witcher 3 on next gen should be the entire experience, including both sizable expansions Hearts of Stone and Blood and Wine, and other smaller content that has come to the game post-launch. Since PC was involved in the announcement, The Witcher 3 seems to be getting visual upgrades across the board. The PS5 will be able to run it in 4K, most likely at higher frame rates than that achieved by the PS4 Pro. Some of these enhancements are reportedly coming from The Witcher 3 version using fan mods as part of the basis for the updates. The PS5's SSD will likely slash load times, which were notoriously long following the game's initial launch. Though these were made shorter with the updates, the PS5 should still be much faster. PlayStation 5 owners are probably hoping for a haptic feedback and adaptive trigger support, but there hasn't been any confirmation on that front. And as The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt is a third-party game, there's no way to know until CD Projekt Red says one way or the other. So that's going to do it for the article. Again, the details are super scarce now. My prediction for the release date is going to be around December 17th when the Season 2 of The Witcher Netflix series drops. I know August 23rd we're getting The Witcher Nightmare of the Wolf, some cartoon show on Netflix, but this show with Henry Cavill is getting Season 2 in December, and that's why I'm assuming we can we'll start to see that new upgrade for the consoles. I'm hoping it's sooner because I've kind of put the game on pause. Like I've just played through the storyline again. And I haven't played the expansions yet, but I'm like, do I want to play through them now and only have one expansion to play when the upgrade comes out? Because I'm not really going to want to replay through the storyline. I know you can, and I know there's so many different options you can take. I just don't want to do it. It's, you know, a commitment that you got to really be dedicated for. However, I do love the game, and I just want to see it in all its glory. So I will probably just hold off until this expansion comes out and the updates. I really hope for some new news soon. It's really kind of getting to the point where it's like, you announced it, but can we get a date? Can we get at least a little more details? I am excited to see what they do as far as the DLC, like with the Netflix's series content. Because I know that show was prior to, it's a younger Geralt. It's not Witcher 3 Geralt, who's like 50 something, but I'd be interested to see what happens, or if they add in, you know, playing as Henry Cavill's Geralt, if that's like a character skin you can add, or his armor and swords and whatnot, maybe even the stance where he uses the sword upside down. I don't know, but whatever it is, just, you know, be on the lookout for it. We'll continue to cover it on this channel. So just like I said, make sure to turn on the notifications and subscribe so you guys can stay up to date on all the latest gaming news that I love to talk about. If you guys have suggestions on games you want to cover on this channel, please let me know in the comments and we can dive into those as well. I know there's a lot of great stuff coming out, so got lots to cover. Let me know what you guys think. But if you guys did enjoy this video, as always, just smash the thumbs up button, kind of help get the video out there. Consider subscribing to the channel if you enjoy these types of videos and gaming news and media updates. And just turn on the notification bell so you guys never miss uploads. And like I said before, if you're a new subscriber, make sure to just let us know down in the comments. Stay on the lookout for the giveaway. All the information for that's in the description. As always, I will see you guys next time.